Trooper. Not a single one of those gifts is addressed to the trooper.
What's up with that? I don't get a gift?
So today is a new day. Today is Wednesday. I am in Las Vegas because this is where I live. I'm on the strip to play poker because that's what I do. I didn't eat yet, so I think I'll probably grab a small bite to eat at the old Starbucks. And I'm thinking I'm gonna play at Bally's. It's kinda early. I don't even think it's 4 yet. It might be 4 p.m.-ish. Looks like it's 3:52 to be exact. It is nice and chilly out here today. Oh, you know what? Man, I kind of feel like having an Italian beef sandwich from Giordano's. You know what? I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna get something quick and easy. Holy shit, look at that line. Mobile order action.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I really wanted the chorizo meat disc sandwich. I said it, meat disc. I know, right? There's nobody there. Anyway, they're all out of it. Had to settle for the old double smoked bacon action. I know that in the last vlog, I sort of left you hanging a little bit and I was a little bit cryptic and I was saying things like, not gonna play poker and vlog about it forever. And the truth is, I'm not gonna play poker and vlog about it forever. But the question is, am I gonna do it for 10 more years? One more year? 30 more years? 30 more years is not forever, right? I guess the point is that I have a renewed energy for what I should have been doing my whole life anyway, and that is running a business. And the thing is, it's kind of hard for me to, I haven't always known exactly what I wanted to do. I have an idea, a big idea, that I want to do later, like years down the road, but I have an idea that I want to do actually tomorrow. I want to get up tomorrow and start this new thing that I want to do. When I moved here to Vegas, I moved here to play poker and vlog about it, make my YouTube videos. But when I came here, the original idea was to make a living playing poker, right? Mainly survive playing poker. I've never wanted to play 5-10. I've never wanted to get into really higher stakes or whatever. I should probably be playing 2-5 on a regular basis, and the reason I haven't been playing 2-5 for months is because of just being a little too conservative. Conservative because I do get income from YouTube. I make money from YouTube, right? But it's kind of done like one of these numbers, right? And it's not enough money for me to feel comfortable with my overall live role or whatever. That's all beside the point. The point is that at some point here, we're gonna have to stop running around trying to survive, and we're gonna have to start to thrive. There's actually a difference. There's a big difference in survive and thrive. I mean, I'm actually an expert survivor, an absolute expert at surviving. I've been doing it since fifth grade. I was actually a thriver through fourth grade, and then in fifth grade, life changed a little bit. I stopped caring as much, and I started just doing enough to get by. For some reason, that has sort of stuck with me through life. But over the last couple years, I've been making a change on that. I've actually been trying to do more, push myself. The YouTube videos, the Trooperware, you know, all of this stuff has helped really renew my energy and my excitement for business and for working for myself and being in business for myself. I am in business for myself. I have been for a while, playing poker, making YouTube videos. That's in business for myself. You know, I know what I want to do. There's two versions of it, but this is something that I could do a lot sooner than later. There's actually two ways to approach this. Number one, I could probably get investors and get started very quickly, you know? The problem is, though, is I would be selling pieces of myself, you know? Selling pieces of the business, and I don't really want to do that, because starting a business, there's risk, right? But for me, and what I'm talking about doing specifically, there is no risk. I don't believe there's risk at all. And the way that I intend to do it, I intend to really be a David right in the face of a Goliath. And that looks like risk, but I am 1,000% confident in my ability to succeed at what I will be doing. And so the risk is in selling pieces, because I'm risking all the upside. There is no downside. There's no downside to this. So if I get the money together on my own and I start a business, and I risk everything, I'm right where I am right now. You know, the point is, this whole moving to Vegas to build something out of nothing, that whole idea is about to really start taking a turn and start to take shape. Because the truth of the matter is that at the end of the day, for me, for some people it's different, but for me, poker's not fulfilling. Poker's fun. Poker was a way to work for myself and be lazy, which, by the way, doesn't work that well. And truth is, if I loved poker to the extent that I should have loved poker in order to take it on the way that I did, I would be thriving. And the reason I don't thrive is because it's not fulfilling and I get bored. I didn't exactly intend to reveal all of this today, but why is there a better time than right now to tell you what's really going on, you know? But when it comes to playing more poker, what I said in the last vlog, and taking poker more seriously, what I mean by that is that poker is now just a job. And I haven't made a lot of money this year from poker because I've played so few hours. I've played an embarrassing number of hours of poker this year, and that is the truth. You can't expect in the number of hours that I've played, especially 1-2 and 1-3, to have really set the world on fire and have like a huge bankroll or whatever. In fact, it would be pretty improbable to survive with the number of hours I play. YouTube plus poker plus Trooperware, all of that stuff together, you know, allows me to survive. But I still haven't been really thriving. As for now, I'm gonna continue to play poker, but for now, poker has a new purpose. Poker has a new place in my life and in the journey and in the story. And poker needs to be a vehicle by which I acquire the money to start the next thing. And I'm not gonna tell you what the next thing is, and I'm not gonna tell you what the name of it is, which I have strong ideas about all of that stuff. All of that stuff has been taking place in here, it just hasn't been taking place in there. And, you know, I'm just beginning to touch on it a little bit and let you know, you know. So if you're a fan of my vlog and you're a fan of me and my journey, just, I am telling you, the story is about to get really, really good. And what I am going to do, I'm going to do in a very colorful, an extremely bold and audacious manner. As for today, I'm still a poker player, so I'm going to go play poker. Say what's up to Victoria and Dan from London?
Close enough. England.
Somewhere around London. Or no, somewhere in England. I'm glad that you refer to England as a country. People try to tell me it's not.
It definitely is.
Yeah. It's believe not, it is.
Yeah, I got it. Look at Victoria. Look at her phone. Oh, it's so bright it won't even like. It has a case that has lights for pictures.
And it gets brighter.
Vlog fans from all the way across the pond. I love that. And she gave me fudge from her company where she works. And I'm gonna eat every bit of it. Also, thanks to Victoria and Dan for giving me the opportunity to come get another coffee. Because this coffee is so good today. Which way do I wanna go? Let's go this way. I really like the way that, put it this way, I really like my mindset for the first 3 hours of poker tonight. And it's a mindset that is difficult to hold on to for me. It actually involves a high level of focus and concentration, and also a high level of determination, you know? The thing is that it's hard for me to stay focused at the poker table for a long period of time. Usually the only way for me to get to be focused like that for a long period is to be stuck. And the determination grows. I would never do what I'm about to say, but if I actually did try Adderall or crystal meth, like a little bit, I would probably be able to murder poker for long periods of time because of the focus and the concentration. But I would never do that. So I'm left to let my mind wander to 1,000 different things. And oh, look at that.
I want a hat.
How are you, man?
I want a hat.
I got hats. Okay, you want look at that sweatshirt.
Hey, will you do me a favor? Two favors?
What up, Harley and Presley? So hey, shout out to Tom, and I don't know where your wife is, but she's around somewhere. She's wearing a trooper shirt too.
Here's my wife right here, go gamble.
Look at that.
I know.
Yeah, nice go gamble. What do you call it, hoodie? That's so much fun to run into people randomly who are wearing my sweatshirts or whatever. It's just awesome. Yo, it is now the end of Wednesday night for me. I am going to go home, edit this vlog. Tomorrow I gotta get up, do some things, and then it's Westgate time tomorrow night, 6 o'clock. know, that music right there was a dude playing that music on the bridge right there was like the perfect music for like the current State of the Trooper. You know, I haven't done a State of the Trooper address in a while. I think that today may have actually been a State of the Trooper address, if you think about it, right? We kind of do it every day, but today I opened up a little bit more into, like, you know, I don't know, what's going on more than just the day-to-day, right? But, yeah, you know, change is something very, very weird for me. And, you know, I don't know what it is, but, like, I don't know how to explain it. If I make a move, even if it's a good move and it's an improvement, you know, whether it be a geographical move or a, you know, like a job move or something like that, there's always this, like, sentimental, like, bit of, you know, sadness or missing the old place. And I think it comes from childhood, because we moved around so much. When I was a kid, it was like, I just remember being really, really sad whenever we would move, because I just got used to, like, my room and where we lived and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a negative thing necessarily. It's just a sentimental thing. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. What you talking about, some sentimental? What are you being sentimental? I mean, I got feelings. Trooper got feelings. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, should I check now, see if there's any gifts under there for me now? You know what, you want to hear the truth? Truth of the matter is, I don't want there to be any gifts under there for me. That's the truth. The gifts that I would want can't go in a box under a tree. There's some sentimental for you. Yo, in motion, across the food court on my way to the parking garage at Caesars. Allow me to remind you that if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. Yo, I'm gonna see you next time.